Hi everyone, good Sunday afternoon. Meteorologist Griffin Hardy here with an update on your forecast. It is a lovely day in the upstate, just a bit crisp, but lots of sunshine on that Woodruff Road sky cam, looking up towards the Blue Ridge Mountains, which are living up to their name today, and clear skies across the upstate. Spartanburg sitting at 55, 57 in Greenville, 58 in Anderson, and also around the same in Asheville as well. A little cloudier in western North Carolina, definitely on that Asheville sky cam, where there's a bit more moisture in the mid and upper levels of the atmosphere. That's why we have a very small chance for some isolated showers overnight tonight. Not so much in the upstate. We'll keep with a clear sky tonight, and it will be cold, but not as cold as last night. Temperatures will only get down to the mid 30s and low 40s overnight, whereas, you know, we were below freezing early this morning. That is because warmer air is coming in. We've got upper 60s and low 70s in Alabama and central Tennessee right now, where winds are coming out of the south. That's the general pattern for the next 3 days, with south winds taking over. We'll be about 10, 15 degrees warmer for tomorrow afternoon. Here's what it looks like hour by hour for tonight, 9 to 10 o'clock. That's when we'll have some possible occasional showers in western North Carolina, but stay mostly clear and relatively warmer in the upstate for tonight. The temperatures in the mid 40s by 10 o'clock, and then upper 30s to low 40s when you wake up early tomorrow, mid 30s in the mountains with, again, a stray shower possible. Then that dries up and we see the sunshine come out for all of us for tomorrow as those south winds turn a little breezy tomorrow. It'll be up to around 10 to 15 miles per hour, but that is what's going to help warm us up. We'll briefly touch 70 degrees in many places. It'll be just lovely in the afternoon. Lots of sunshine, very comfortable. Should be all in all a very beautiful day. That south winds keep temperatures still warm-ish for tomorrow evening, with temperatures in the mid-50s by then. But unfortunately, the trade-off with the south winds means more moisture as well. We'll have a chance for some on-again, off-again showers starting Tuesday morning, and that will continue throughout the day Tuesday into the afternoon. Still some more occasional showers possible. And heading into Wednesday as well, this overall pattern that we're in favors a better chance for some rain. That'll be for Wednesday morning as well. And then eventually a cold front comes in late in the day Wednesday evening in particular. We have a chance for some thunderstorms along that cold front. The front itself does look pretty stout, but I don't think it'll be overall too favorable of a setup for severe weather. We will get thunderstorms out of it, though, and some occasional heavy rain, or brief heavy rain, I should say. That'll come in Wednesday night at around 9, 10 o'clock, it looks like. So plan on some heavy rain Wednesday night into Thursday morning. That's why we're issuing an impact day for that. Drying out Thursday behind that front and turning a little chillier again. It'll be about 3 days where we have upper 60s and low 70s for highs, and then we'll be pretty chilly for the rest of the week heading into the weekend. We're not quite in full spring mode yet, but we do have another chance of rain that'll come in Friday and into Saturday. And next weekend's forecast is still a bit unsettled, with models still kind of split on whether we're going to be dry for Saturday, Sunday, or whether or not we'll see some occasional showers. For now, here's what the rain chances look like for the next 7 days. Bone dry for tomorrow, spotty showers Tuesday. It'll turn scattered Wednesday evening in particular, and then dry back out Thursday. Then another chance for some rain moves in Friday and possibly sticks around for next weekend. Those high temperatures for 3 days will be reminiscent of what you would see in March, but not lasting all week long. Again, behind that front will be chillier. We'll go from 70s and upper 60s down to the 50s again by Thursday and for Friday. Overnight tonight, again, cold, but not as cold as overnight last night. Mid 30s to low 40s across the area. 36 your low tonight for Spartanburg, 40 for Greenville, mid 30s for Anderson, Greenwood, and Abbeville. Same for western North Carolina. Only spot hitting freezing. The freezing mark will be Franklin. Overnight into tomorrow afternoon, lovely day tomorrow. Sunny, breezy, but very comfortable. Upper 60s and low 70s across the board. Here's what I've got for the 4 day. Again, sunny and breezy for tomorrow. Cloudy skies and staying kind of rainy throughout the day Tuesday. Impact day Wednesday with that chance for thunderstorms in the evening, lasting into the pre-dawn hours of Thursday. Thursday afternoon, we're drying out and turning a little colder. High goes from 70 down to 56 between Wednesday and Thursday. Then some more occasional chances for some rain Friday and possibly Saturday, Sunday, but low confidence on that. We're probably going to have to adjust it as we get a little bit closer, as models are still kind of split on the idea of whether or not we'll get rain Saturday into Sunday. 40 plus for the mountains looks like this. Not quite so warm, but still good chances for rain Tuesday and Wednesday. Instead of 70s, we're going to see upper 60s in the mountains, and again turning colder on Thursday back behind that front with some more possible on-again, off-again showers Friday and potentially into next weekend. Have a great rest of your Sunday night, everybody.